Good afternoon to one and all present here. I am Raghav. I am here to present our research topic, Redefining Smartness in Township with Internet of Things and Artificial Intelligence, Dholera City. Dholera, the new era of smart city, it's the visionary project of India. I know many of the people here don't know what is the Dholera concept, but this is the new thing that India is doing right now. The aim of the presentation is to share the key points of our research. First, I will tell you the normal problems that a city faces. So what is the problem for these normal cities? That is smart city. But again, there are some problems with the smart city. So we need a good solution. And that we will discuss, then literature review. And again, we will let you know what is Dholera, Dholera features, and at lastly, conclusion. Concept of urbanization. The population of India is about 1.5 billion. From which for 34% of population live in urban cities and the rest in rural area. But as the time goes, the population in the urban cities is going to increase. So are our cities capable to accommodate them? The answer is no. Are the ordinary cities functioning well? The answer is no. Every one of you might have visited the urban city like you are living in Pune itself. So we know what are the problems the Pune city is facing right now. So the current problems in the ordinary cities are like slum areas, internet, interconnectivity, environmental damage, irregular traffic and infrastructure management. But what are the causes of this problem? The main or the important cause of this problem is increasing population, then lack of urban resources and unplanned infrastructure. Because while developing the cities, we never thought about the future. We didn't have a vision. So that's the reason we are facing this problem. So this seems to be that urbanization is causing so many problems. But so we should leave the urbanization? We should stop the urbanization? No, this is not the solution for it. Because our economy is dependent on urban city. Mumbai, it's the central hub for the business. So we can't stop urbanization. We need a better solution. So a normal solution for this is smart city. Smart cities make a use of information and communication technology to overcome this problem faced in ordinary cities and increase the standard of living. But we have seen recently, like in many urban cities which are just converted into smart city or are being converted into smart city, they also face various problems. Like just a rain comes, there is a flood and situation. So that means a smart city cannot tackle this problem also. So we need a more better solution. What is the better solution? The better solution is that we should create a smart city from the greenfield. That is the greenfield smart city. A brownfield city is a which is just a normal city. We are converting that into the smart city. That is called a brownfield smart city. But we need now a greenfield smart city. So, Dholera SIR is the first greenfield smart city of India. Urban, the literature review. One of the authors told that urban resources and infrastructure has already stretched beyond the capacity due to the increasing population. So, there are some features that must be there in urbanization. What are they? They are optimized use of resources. Every person in that city must get a proper resources. There should not be inequality in distribution and there should be some limitation. There should be a proper rule. Then connected and transparent public services, a proper metro or bus service must be there so that public will use that only. Better safety and security. It's not the responsibility of the government to always provide a safety and security. It should be done by the citizen itself. But smart city is a concept of economic growth. If there is smart city, proper infrastructure, indirectly we will have a good FDI investment. So there will be a proper economic growth. There will be employability, due to which the quality of the life of the people will increase. Infrastructure should be well and ICT. Smart city IoTCR focuses on the interconnection among the city infrastructure. There should be a proper connection among the city. There should be mesh network connectivity, automated water supply and traffic management. There must be a use of sensors, a different kind of sensor like SCADA, GPR, hydraulic pressure sensor. Dholera. It is India's first industrial greenfield city on barren land. Note that it's a barren land. In India, we have much land which is barren. So we must focus on greenfield city. Then ICT is being used for social and economic impact. That means there will be a two-way communication and a proper communication without a barrier between the government and the public. No barrier. So that there should be a proper communication. Dholera is a plug and play business model. The plug and play. It's generally used in business model. But here, Dholera is a plug and play because the infrastructure is properly built. Everything is ready. Just a proper investor or a business manager should just need to visit the office, that is ABCD building. there is a single window. You need to apply for the business and other licenses. All your licenses, business clearance will be done within the one day. That's the creativity vision for this city. So an investor can go easily and start a business. Infrastructure is ready, employees are ready, the slaves are ready, everything is there. So we can go with that also. Dholera has electric mobility. The project of Dholera is going to complete in 2042. So just imagine, by that time, we will have 100% electric vehicles. And as well as Dholera, the plan which is just proposed for 2042, in that it's clearly mentioned that we will only allow electric vehicles. So the major concern of pollution is going to be completely solved. As in Delhi, we see the pollution is a major factor. It's the capital of India. So that problem is going to be solved. It's a global fest for living and as well as business hub. It focuses on renewable energy. This is a big fact for it, that there will be solar panels installed in Dholera which will generate 5000 megawatt of electricity which is required by alone state of Bihar for the 1 year. Imagine just seeing how it's the big project. A state Bihar required 5000 megawatt and that alone city will generate that much electricity. The vision is clear. Problems that are caused due to pollution are lower IQ, hypertension, weak memory, and all those problems are being solved by Dholera. And it has the capacity to handle 5 million people. There are some features of Dholera that must be focused, that are leak-free land. The infrastructure is planned such way that in the future, after 100 to 200 years, if there is something new infrastructure, that is a leak-free land, that is a trunk infrastructure. No need to damage the infrastructure again and again. Once it builds, it's there for every time. Smart water management, SPPs are also properly installed. There are artificial rivers. This is a new concept. Artificial rivers are there. If a flood-like situation occurs or the rainwater is more, the water will directly go to the artificial river. Now there might be a point that if there is artificial river, there might be again flood-like situation, but it's not like that. Dholera location is such that it's located to the seaport. Seaport and there is a canal. If the water level goes up in the artificial river, the canal will directly open and the water will flow out. That also sea. That means the nearing regions will also not get affected from it. That's the vision for it. There is a logistic connectivity. It has an international airport, railway, metro and highway as well as seaport because the sea is near to it. Wireless sensor system. Streetlight architecture is there. The streetlights are connected wirelessly to each other. There is a central system where all the streetlights will report. If a streetlight goes off, then directly the report will be at the central server. So the action will be taken fast. Then internet connected system. If there is internet, obviously the communication is going to be faster and the action will be taken faster. The conclusion from all this are that till 2042, according to the UN report, till 2042 the world will require 10,000 new cities. 10,000 new cities. That means if we are going to create such cities like Dholera from now onwards, the Dholera city is taking 40 years to complete. 40 years for. So we need to make this project faster. India requires more 50 projects like Dholera. Then only we can compete with the future generation. Because Dholera is a greenfield smart city. Green. Dholera works on green. That is recreation, education, awareness, public art, and economic growth. It focuses on all the aspects of a public life. The SCADA sensors are used properly in the pipeline so that it will help in decision making. The water management is the best, I think, that's done in the Dholera. There are three pillars for the Dholera project, that is smart infrastructure, energy, and wastewater management. These are the some references we have done. And acknowledgement, we would like to acknowledge MIT DT University for giving us this opportunity, EVF conference coordinators, as well as we have visited the Dholera. So Dholera team people are so grateful that they gave us all the information and our guides. Thank you. Right now the phase 1 project is completely finished. So we have even seen that the SCADA systems are placed very properly. So the project is in running. Phase 1 is going to complete by 2022 and about 90% of the project work is being completed. I have personally visited the field. Yeah. Cost for Dholera. The government has sanctioned 2 lakh crores for this. And the Gujarat government is paying all the state government is paying all the fees, all the requirement. The central government has not contributed till now, but I hope the central government will also contribute in it. It's the visionary project of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi. While he was CM, he started this project.
Right now, that time I visited, they were saying like the lines are for being sale, but the price at that, I don't know exact value, but they have told me that the when we started this project, that from that time the price are being 5 times higher. And the villagers, the local people are there, they are selling this land because they don't know much about this project itself, the local land, because they are from rural areas. So. Thank you.